Yo, Adam Saxon with Guy in the Cuban. In this video, let's talk about the orphans, those workspaces that are just lonely and far apart. If you're finding us for the first time, be sure to hit that subscribe button to stay up to date with all the videos between Patrick and myself. All right, orphaned workspaces. What are we talking about? So an orphan workspace is a workspace that doesn't have any members. So it's just kind of off on its own. No one can get to it. No one can do anything, but it's still active. You may want to go through and clean those up and get rid of them, but there are challenges with doing that. All right, enough of all this talking. You know how we like to do it here on Guy in the Cube. Let's do what? Let's head over to my machine. So as an admin, I can come into the admin portal and I can go to workspaces. And if you sort the state descending, the orphaned workspaces will bubble up to the top. And you can see that I have an orphaned workspace here. Whose workspace is this? If we actually go and look at details, we'll get the actual workspace ID so we can validate that. Keep this GUID handy. That's something important to know. And if I go to the access list, you'll see that there's no one listed in this workspace. That's why it's orphaned. Now, the other challenge I have here is I can't delete this workspace. There's a bunch of clicks that I have to do here. I have to recover the workspace, or I could just go to access and add a user in there. I will then have the option to delete that workspace. As I've heard before from someone else, that employs a heavy click tax to the operation. So we're not lazy here on Guy in the Cube. We're just efficient. So how do I efficiently get rid of these orphan databases? That's where APIs and PowerShell come into play. That's right. You knew I was going to go there. We need to script this out in order to be efficient. So let's go look at a script. Shout out to Alex Powers who put this together originally. Actually ran it. It hit a problem. So I added an extra step in there. I'll have a link to this script down in the description below over to the GitHub repo that Alex has where this is located. So you can go check that out if you would like. So I'm going to go to my friend VS Code. And in here, what we're going to do on line number 5 is we're going to go get a list of the workspaces that are orphaned. One thing you'll notice here is I'm using scope organization because I need to do this as a Power BI admin to be able to look at all the workspaces across the organization. Line number 7, this is the email address. This should be your email address. So we're going to inject an admin into the workspace. In order to run the delete command, it needs to be you because you're running the script. So whatever you're logged in as to run this script, that should be the email that we put on line 7. Line number 9 is just going to tell you how many total orphan workspaces, and then we're going to loop through those workspaces. So for each workspace, what I'm going to do on line 20 is I'm going to inject the email address that I listed above as an admin of the workspace. The reason I have to do this is because the delete action of a workspace is not an admin API, meaning that actually I have to have ownership of the workspace and I have to be an admin of the workspace in order to perform that delete command. So that's why I have to inject myself as the admin in order to do this. And then once that user's injected on line 23, I'm actually going to delete that actual workspace. And so these are the URLs that it's using: the PowerShell cmdlet invoke Power BI REST method, and then just actually calling the REST API directly using the PowerShell cmdlets, because there's not an actual PowerShell cmdlet to do these actions. So ideally this should all work. Let's give it a try. I'm just going to select all of it and then we're going to run the selection. And when we look, we can see down here, total orphan workspaces, it found one. This was the GUID of the workspace that it echoed. Cool. That looks like it worked. Let's go back to the portal and see what happened here. So it still shows as orphan. Let's refresh. And then we can see that we are deleted. Let's sort descending. Whose workspace is this anyway? Now shows deleted. Bananas. It's a two-step operation. We've got to add the user and then we've got to delete the workspace. If you have a ton of orphaned workspaces, this will just go through and handle all of them for you. Also of note, this is specific to workspace V2, not the old workspaces. So hopefully you've migrated everything over to workspace V2 because we cannot add a user using this REST API to the V1 workspace because it's bound to the Office 365 stuff. So it's a little different, but if it's a workspace V2, this should just work. All right, I want to hand this over to you. Have you struggled with orphan workspaces, not knowing what to do with them? Did you even know that they existed? Does this help you? Let me know in the comments below. We'd love to hear it. If you like this video, be sure to give it a big thumbs up. Smash it if you so desire. If it's your first time here, hit that subscribe button. And as always, from both Patrick and myself, thanks for watching. Keep being awesome, and we'll see you in the next video.